We meet with automakers from all around the world quite regularly because we're trying to get them all to increase their production in the U.S. The German manufacturers are all operating very, very close to their U.S. capacity, and on balance, we're a big net importer of cars from Germany and parts for German cars, both from Germany, from Austria, and from Mexico. So we're trying to reduce that deficit. Our car and car part trade deficit with Germany is around $30 billion. It's almost half of our total trade deficit with Europe. So it's a very, very important component of the European situation, and autos and auto parts are a big part of the global. If we don't fix auto and auto part trade deficit and the Chinese trade deficit, we're not going to get anywhere. They're each more or less half the total.
The Commerce Department, your Commerce Department, has reportedly been circulating some draft recommendations in terms of whether it thinks the White House should be imposing a 25% tariff on those European cars. Can you tell us anything about that right now?
Yes, the drafting of the report and the analysis that goes into it have been underway for quite a little while, and we're going through our normal interagency review process. That's a process designed to make sure that State Department, Treasury, National Security Council, all the relevant departments, agriculture, everybody has a look at the report, White House Counsel and Justice Department vet it, so that we make sure that it's something that can stand on its own when it becomes released. President, as you know, has said that he will not impose tariffs in autos on the Europeans as long as negotiations with them are making good progress. So the timing of this whole thing will largely be driven by what happens in negotiations. China, we don't really import very much in the way of cars, and we do import some parts. So it's a very, very complicated picture, but we're moving along at a very deliberate and very orderly pace.
What would a successful negotiation with the EU look like in terms of automakers?
Well, as I said, we have a total deficit with them of $65 billion, of which about half is from cars. So some meaningful reduction in that, hopefully mainly by increased production in the U.S. For example, they all have big programs for electric cars. It's very important to us to get a lot of the manufacturing for electric cars done in the U.S. That's one of the big objectives we have. And toward that end, we recently had the announcement from SK, a very major company from Korea, that they're building a very big electric battery plant in the U.S. That's a terrific development for us, because that starts the supply chain.